Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This is a very, very special multimeter. It's a SOAR 3620 bar graph multimeter. So it's a bar graph, LCD bar graph. Really, really special. And it can zoom and do minimum and maximum, and also it's really, really special. I just took out the screw, and when I opened it, I got... Are you ready to cry? Prepare for monster battery puke down. So we got three. So the socket is for three, but only two are mounted, and they are just in complete meltdown, mega puke. Oh no! Will I ever be able to restore this into a testable, workable? Prepare for next clip. That is going to be a sad, sad story. Oh, that was so, so bad. I took out the batteries, and it looks like this unit uses both the positive and the negative side, and then the center point is also connected. Look at that. I think I need to unscrew the main board and see how everything looks and clean this all the way up, because we could have battery acids, see, all the way into good stuff. So there's a really good rotary encoder or the contact here. This feels fantastic. Maybe we can open this and restore it. That would be great if we could repair this. So I opened it and everything fell apart quite easily. You got the buttons there out. Two little tiny springs that connects to the beeper. That's pretty cool. And they connect to the top side of the board. Those two pads, right? But where is all the electronics? It's probably hidden underneath the display. It's probably a system on chip or some. There's a chip under here, but I think I need to remove the display to be able to to clean this up, because I think all the acids actually followed the contacts all the way into everything. Oh, that is a bad state of... But of course, sometimes I get stuff for free, and it is just in a close to useless status. But sometimes it is restorable, and probably I can fix this. At least I will give it a try, because I think it's a cool and fun challenge. So I will remove the display and desolder the battery. So I took off the frame that holds the display, and the display is of course connected to the PCB with them standard rubber contacts. So that is all quite normal. And then there's a shield underneath the display, and that is connected to half the voltage. So that is the only thing that it does, really, I think. Maybe this is connected to something else, but I can actually desolder this, and then I should be able to remove the battery casing here. So this is the backside of the display. I got a little bit of acid around the crystal. I tried to clean it the best I could. I also cleaned all the contacts. And here we go with the battery. contacts here. This one is nice and clean. This is how I want them to look. And this one is, I need to clean it. Still feels like there's good metal in there. There's still nice and good springs in them. So I think I just need to clean them. They went into hot water and soap for quite a while. Like every plastic part and everything here went into hot water and soap. Also, all the plastic parts here. And now it is nice and shiny. even this one. So now I look so much forward to assemble it and see if it's alive. I am sad to say that it is impossible to fix this. But see, I got a little bit of life when I turned it on and off. But that is basically all that happens. I am powering it up with plus minus 1.5 volts. So that will be to simulate the two cells. And there's just nothing more I can do. Damn it. Could have been fun to play with this one because it's really, really special.